Hello, developers. I am David Ortnow, a product manager on the .NET team working with .NET MAUI. And we have a new release that I'd like to spend a few minutes sharing with you and give you the highlights. So let's take a look. So we have .NET MAUI now in the .NET 7 release candidate 1. The .NET 7 previews have been going for several months. And of course, .NET MAUI GA'd in or general availability in May of the year of this year. So what that means is that we've been shipping service releases since May, and now we are joining .NET 7 with release candidate 1. So you get all of the latest improvements, but even more than that, we've got some goodies for you as well. So how can you get this? It is available to you in Visual Studio 2022, version 17.4 preview 2.1. That's a lot of numbers. But essentially, if you go grab the latest preview on both Windows and Mac, you will get the .NET 7 RC1, which will include, as long as you've checked the box, the .NET MAUI workload so that you can build Android, iOS, Mac, and Windows apps from a single code base. So when you first start a new application, something new is going to happen for you. You will be able to choose between .NET 6 and .NET 7 with the framework selector. So you can continue to build .NET 6 apps or open and build your existing .NET 6 apps from this build as well. Even though .NET 7 is the newest version of .NET on your system, that will not prevent you from continuing forward with .NET 6. Huge shout out to our .NET team and project system teams and everybody who was involved to make this work, because I think it's one of the first times that we've ever done that. So that's really a nice benefit for us as developers. The main update that you will make, let's say that you wanted to bring a .NET 6 project to .NET 7 for .NET MAUI, super simple. Change the 6 to a 7 in the target framework moniker. We often refer to these as TFMs. Try not to use the acronym too much, but essentially in your CS project, or if you just edit your project file, you'll notice like the XML here at the bottom of the slide, that there is a series of target frameworks that are supported in this project. Just turn those 6s to 7s, and you have found yourself in .NET 7 release candidate 1. So what all is new for you as a .NET MAUI developer in this release? One of the things that we've heard from developers, especially those coming from Xamarin, is we need mobile maps. It's a popular component that is available in Xamarin Forms, and as yet we had not brought it to .NET. So it is now available with .NET 7 RC1. It also will work on Mac, and then we'll talk about Windows in just a minute. We also will have dual screen support coming out. That ships as a separate NuGet package, so you can look for that to be available on NuGet. We have a series of desktop enhancements to round out our, not round out, it's not the end of the story, but to fill some of those top needs for desktop developers. We have some performance improvement updates for you, as always, that are very exciting. And then generally, and this is perhaps the biggest bucket of things, is quality and reliability improvements. We want to make sure that you feel confident as you build your .NET MAUI apps that it does what it says. So what about performance? Well, 53% faster than Xamarin Forms. That's an awesome number. So this is a startup time, which is predominantly important on Android devices. And so this means from the time that you hit the app to the time that it's usable in your hand, how long does that take? It's much faster in .NET 7 now than it was in Xamarin Forms. So and if you're using Xamarin Android and moving to .NET Android, or Xamarin iOS moving to .NET for iOS, you will see similar and even better performance improvements. But startup performance is just one part of the story. What about the ability to refresh the screen quickly? Moving from screen to screen, how fluid is it? Are we removing jank from those transitions and any other animations? And so there's a test that the team has been kind of iterating on called the lols test. So laugh out loud, right? You got to have fun while you're working. And so what this does is it throws a bunch of views on the screen and iterates on them as quickly as possible. So a higher number is a better number. And as you can see from Xamarin Forms to .NET 6 to .NET 7, improvements are constantly being made. And so if you look at Jonathan Pepper's most recent performance blog post, you can find a lot of information about what has been done under the hood to make that happen. And more work is coming. But as you can see, we're really excited with the progress that we're making. So if you're looking for that better performance overall, come on over to .NET 7. This is where you're going to find it. Going back to the maps that I talked about a moment ago. So Android and iOS, you have maps. You can put markers. You can annotate the map. You can draw polygons on it. You can make your favorite running app clone or cycling. Your Uber clone, your car clone. And it also works on Mac Catalyst because Catalyst is using the same UI kit controls that iOS uses for the most part. And so it just kind of works there by default. WinUI 3 has on the roadmap a map control, but it's not there yet. So what you can do in the interim, if you need the map control on Windows, is you can go over to the MAUI Community Toolkit and you will find a pull request that will show you how to implement a handler for Windows that wraps a map control in a browser instance. So it's a nice solution that keeps you using the same API for a map control, and you get it on all four platforms. So that's a good way to start. And when WinUI 3 comes out with their map control that's native to the platform, then we will implement that and bring it into the box in .NET MAUI. The code is very similar to what you would have experienced previously with Xamarin Forms. You simply drop a map on the screen. You can do more in XAML here if you wish, but you can see that it's super easy from C# to use the onNavigated to event. Every content page in a MAUI app has an onNavigated to event. This is probably the best place for you to put initialization code for your view logic. So not using onAppearing, but using onNavigated to. And then you see here, I'm setting up some latitude, longitude for a location, applying it to a map span, putting it on the screen, and then adding a pin with a label. And that's what we saw. If I pop back to the previous screen, on there. So that is actually the island of Maui, in case that wasn't entirely obvious. So what about the desktop enhancements that I mentioned at the beginning? So context menus, tooltips, pointer gestures, and window size and positioning. These were kind of some of the top feedback items that we heard from customers and from you developers that were using the product. When you're building for desktop, you need these things. Context menus, as you can see in the lower left on the screen here, when you right-click on any view element, any layout, wherever, you can attach several flyout items. They can be multi-tiered, so you can have a hierarchy to your menus as well. And you can, you know, as I'm doing here, I'm showing the holy grail of the editor. How can I do bold, italics, and underline inside of a text block, right? And then tooltips, anytime you hover over something, you want to be able to perhaps show some contextual information. It's not interactive information, but it's a label to indicate this is what this is, this is what you might do with it. And so if you look at our blog posts and the upcoming documentation, you'll be able to see that it's a simple property. It's, I believe, tooltip properties, and then you dot what is the text you want to show, and that will do that to any control in the UI. Pointer gestures enable you to do things like hover handling. So we use Visual State Manager in XAML to be able to do, you know, normal state, hovered state, deselected, disabled, all those sorts of states, and have the UI respond when those things change. So you can do the same thing now with the pointer gesture as well as the visual state for the hover. So that's very powerful, and I think that everybody's going to love that. I was looking for it when I was building one of my apps, so That's gratifying. And then window size and position. This is an interesting one in that because .NET MAUI is completely native, you could always tap into native lifecycle events. So for example, on Windows or on Mac, you can say, okay, when the window is created, give me the handle to it so that I can size it and position it on screen. And you can do that using the native APIs of WinUI or with Mac Catalyst. And on the Windows side, if you need to, you could also p-invoke into the Win32 APIs if that's where you need to go, all the way down. So we saw that this was a big need, that a lot of developers were like, hey, I really want to be able to do this. And so we took those same APIs and we just surfaced them in the cross-platform layer. This is kind of the nature of what we can do here. If we find that a lot of developers are writing that platform code for common scenarios like that, and then we can do a proposal and bring those up into the cross-platform layer like we've done with the window size and positioning. So now it's super easy for you to do those things. You don't need to go find example code and paste it in. You just have the APIs right there for you in .NET MAUI. So that's what we have for you right now in Release Candidate 1. Release Candidate 2 is basically in the can and will be making its way out to developers very soon. Where can you go to get started today? Head over to .NET/MAUI. You can get all the information about the product, how to get started with it, where the documentation is, where all of your helpful resources are. And then, of course, you can always reach out to any of the product managers like myself. We have a whole team of us, and we would love to hear from you and find out what you're building with the product. So have fun.